Right, 98.1 WSU, of course, the hottest student station in Atlanta, Georgia. Miss Lauren, I have a caller on the line, the fabulous Tanya Mullings. Say hello to Atlanta, Miss Tanya Mullings.
Hello, how are you feeling tonight?
Right. Yes, thank you so much for calling up the show, Miss Mullings. We just heard your hot single off the album, Not Easy. Absolutely love that one there.
Thank you. I got to give big props to Devante from Tonto Metro, and Devante who produced that track on the Dippy Joe label.
Wow. And ladies and gentlemen, I already told you that Miss Tanya Mullings was nominated at the Juno Awards in Canada, but she just won last night at the 4th Annual Bashment Community Appreciation Awards in Toronto, Canada. Right, Miss Mullings?
Yes, I did. What an honor it was last night.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Tell me more about that.
Well, like I said, it's a big deal winning awards from, like, your community. Those are the words that mean a lot to you because your community is given to you, you know, and they realize what you've done outside of Canada. So it's a big honor for me.
Wow. Oh, my goodness. Absolutely. Love that. Now, tell me more about this single, Not Easy, that we just heard.
Well, Not Easy was produced in Jamaica at Shock and Vibe Studio, but it was produced by Devante from Tonto Metro. And Devante, everybody knows Tonto. I mean, Devante.
Right.
He's not just singing and doing his thing. He also produces as well under his label, Dimmy Joe. So this rhythm was actually done by Ishmael Hammond, and he actually was just, it came up so sudden. We were just in the studio, just like vibing and talking, and the rhythm was playing in the back that Ishmael was fooling around with. And jokingly, we just started joking on the rhythm, and the next thing you know, we wrote the tune in like 10 minutes and voiced, and that was it. And it's like one of the tunes that's doing the best off the album.
Wow. Oh, my goodness. Absolutely love that. So tell me where you're calling from, Tanya. Not Jamaica. You're calling us from Canada, right?
Yes, I'm based in Canada, Toronto, Canada.
Oh, okay. Nice. So do you travel to Jamaica often?
Yes, I do. I do most of my music there. I've been in the business since 89, and I've done all my recording in Jamaica, mostly all my albums. This is actually my 4th album, Music Is My Life. So we visit Jamaica every year from birth. My dad's Jamaican and my mom's Canadian, so that's where the reggae comes from, my daddy.
Okay. So tell me a little bit more about how you got started with music.
Well, I've been in the business since 89. My father, Carl Mullings, was well known in the business since the 60s. His name was Carl Mullings, and he managed and a lot of the veterans in the music business way back in the day in the 60s. So he actually left Jamaica managing bands and came here. He actually managed a well-known musician, Jackie Mathieu, and there's so many names from the veterans that he was involved with. And he came to Canada, and he liked Canada and decided to stay here. And he actually was the first to open 2 West Indian clubs in Canada and then brought reggae music from Jamaica to Canada. And he also co-founded a big parade we have out here called Caravana.
So he was
always into the music business, and of course, myself, he toured a lot when my older sister was born, Carrie Mullings, who's also here in the music business and has a radio show here in Toronto, Canada.
Carrie Mullings,
I'll make this figure up.
Aww.
So he was traveling a lot, basically, when my sister was born, and it came a time when my mother basically wanted him home. So when I was born, he basically pulled a little time away from the music and decided to just do the family thing. And
right.
He never knew, like, when I was young, I always sang. And it was about when I was 15, I got serious about music. And that actually brought my father back into the music business around all the entertainers that he worked with. So being that they were so glad to see Carl Mullings back in the business and doing his thing, all arms were open to embrace me, his daughter. And I worked with, and I'm blessed to have worked with, some of the veterans in the business, and they groomed me to who I am today.
Right. Sounds good. Now, oh my goodness, I'm so excited to just jump into this next single that you have called I Don't Mind. Now, before we get a little bit more into it, I just want to bring this song to Atlanta. I want my listeners to hear it first before we talk about it. Okay, Zion?
All right, no problem.
Right. So what I want you to do now is bring this song to Atlanta right now.
Bring that song, the one you're going to play right now?
Yes, I Don't Mind featuring Morgan Heritage.
Yes, this one's called I Don't Mind featuring Morgan Heritage. Pick up.
All right. Stay on the line, okay, Tanya?
All right.
No reason to judge you, babe. I will always trust you, baby. Now, I can say you've giving me all I've ever wanted, baby. Oh my goodness, Tanya Mullins, you still on the line with me?
I'm here.
All right, this single, we absolutely love it.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes. Now, tell me, how did you manage to line up this one, Tanya, with Morgan Heritage?
Well, that one, I've been in the business a long time. I actually known Morgan Heritage since 1990. We performed together on the first Reggae Sunsplash.
Wow.
So I've known them for years, and it's from that relationship we met. We've kept in touch for all these years, and I actually took a little time off to enjoy my family, and I went back to Jamaica into Bobby Digital Studio, who I worked close with, and bumped into them again, and they're like, girl, when are we going to do the duet? Peter said, and I said, hey, I'm ready. Anytime you're ready, let's go do this.
Right.
Brace.
Sounds good. So tell me more about the concept of this song. Where did that come about?
Well, the concept came from the genius himself, Peter Morgan. He is an amazing writer. I mean, we were like hanging out at the house. We just hung out, went to sleep, got up in the morning, and Peter just says, in the morning we'll deal with the tune. And the lyrics just flow from him. And I don't mind. Like, it's just basically, you go by, I guess, I came up with lyrics and he also did. But I'm very an understanding person, and I have the attitude like, you know, like, you do what you want, I want to do what I want to do. And
right.
Complications. So yeah. The concept came together, like, just being that open. And both of us in the music industry, you know, you go through a relationship that you have to, you deal with people that need to understand what we are in our business, and it's, you need an understanding person that will understand what you're doing in your business.
Most
give you that
definitely.
Freedom to do that.
Yes, yes, yes. So, Miss Tanya Mullins, tell me this. How do you feel about all the things that are going on right now in specifically dancehall music, like with the warring and things like that?
Well, personally, you know, I don't understand the warring and really why it has to be that way, but I mean, to me, some of them, the stuff that's going on, it began back in the days like a fun thing, and it's a hype thing to get the people just, you know, oh, I like this person, I like that person.
Right, right.
Like, you know, it's about selling and the excitement of what they're, I'm going to chat lyrics about this one and then chat it back about this one. But, you know, sometimes I think it's getting a little bit too out of hand. But I think, to me, some of it's some show and some of it's not. But personally, I don't see why we have to go in that direction.
Everybody just make the music and entertain us, please.
Exactly.
That's what I say.
Positive, good music.
Yes. So tell me this, Miss Tanya Mullings. Tell me, what do you have going on for the rest of 2010? You've already, like, it's not even half the year yet, and you've already won awards, been nominated for awards. Oh, my goodness. What do you have coming up next? What can we expect from you?
Well, we're heading out, my sister and I, Carrie Mullins is my manager as well. We're heading out to St. John's next week to the Junos. That's what I'm excited about.
Oh, gosh.
Everybody's pushing for me. They say this is mine. I'm picking it home. But, you know, I got my fingers crossed.
Definitely.
So, because this is actually my fifth Juno nomination, but I haven't won yet. So it will be really nice to bring that home. We're working on some twing, my management and team. And I will definitely keep you updated so you can keep your
list updated. Please. Oh, my goodness. I would absolutely love that. Yes, thank you so much. I know you're just so busy, and I just want to thank you for taking the time out, because I know you have so much things going on right now.
Oh, no, not a problem. I mean, all of this is very nice. Thanks so much for having me.
Anytime. And you keep in touch with us here, and just good luck with everything, and let us know the results of the awards and everything.
I will.
So you have a wonderful, wonderful night.
You too.
All righty. Take care of yourself. We'll be in touch, all right?
Okay.
Okay. Bye. Okay.